Hi, I'm Dave Crowley, Director of the Industrial Arts Program in the Amesbury School System. Welcome to Amesbury High School's Industrial Arts Department. This is the first time anything like this has been attempted, and we hope that it's going to be informative and entertaining for you. And if you have a son or daughter that's going to be a student at Amesbury High School next year, hopefully it'll help them in making decisions when it comes to course registration. We have 18 courses offered next year in 7 different areas, and we like to think that we've got something for everybody. Now, if you're planning on going to work after high school, we can give you some skills and knowledge that will help you get into what we call a job entry level job. If you're planning on education after high school in the technical or engineering fields, we'll give you a running start in that direction also. We think we have something for everybody, so why don't you come along with me and let's take a look at what we have to offer. This is a technical drawing room, and at the moment you can see that we have a Tech Drawing 1 class going on. They're just about finishing up their program. They'll be finished the end of next week. We have 6 different Tech Drawing courses offered. 5 of them are semester in length. In Tech Drawing 1, obviously, you're going to learn about the fundamentals of drafting, some geometric construction, lettering, dimensioning, and some design. Design is emphasized in all the courses. Eventually, they will have to design and draw plans of a small race car. Under first year drawing, you can see some examples of some blueprints of some of the race cars that have been designed. And again, as I said earlier, the emphasis is on fundamentals of industrial drafting. Starting next year, we're going to offer a semester course called Technical Illustrating. And examples of that you can see under the second year drawing area. This kind of drawing is what we call pictorial. They learn about isometrics, obliques, perspectives, they learn about some shading, and they also learn how to do a basic composition in what we call the space scene project. These are examples of drawings done by students from previous years. It's 1 semester in length. Also, we're going to offer as a semester course beginning in the sophomore year a pattern development drawing, which consists of designing and drawing plans of objects that are made out of sheet stock, such as sheet metal. And they're going to design things such as a freestanding metal fireplace and a backyard shelter that might be used by young children. Models are also made in this particular program. In basic machine drafting semester course, you're going to learn the review of orthographic projections and dimensioning, including tolerancing and allowances. And again, the emphasis is on design. You will be designing a small tool or object. You can see some of the examples here, and we talk about creativity, imagination, and invention. Matter of fact, one of my former students presently holds a patent from Washington for a device that he invented after he left high school. We also offer a basic architectural drawing course starting in your junior year. You'll learn about the various symbols, and you'll draw the various symbols used in floor plans, elevations, and wall sections. They'll also design a floor plan for a family room that you might want to add to your home, or you will design, or they will design a plan for a small cabin that they eventually might like to build. As a senior, you can take advanced technical drawing. It's a full year course. In that course, you can select from advanced machine drafting. Examples that you see here on the bulletin board are of objects that are far more complicated and involved. Or you can take advanced architectural drafting. You're going to design a house, draw the floor plans, 2 elevations, a wall section, and a 2-point perspective. Students that graduate from this course are able to get jobs in the areas, and they are able to go on to various technical and engineering schools in mechanical engineering and architectural drafting. graphic arts room. We offer two programs in graphic arts. Basic graphic arts, which is a semester in length, grades 9 through 12, and advanced graphic arts, which is also a semester in length, for grades 11 through 12. Now what we have is a multiple activity room. In graphic arts, the students are going to learn about silk screening process, hand-cut stencils, and photographic. They're going to learn something about letterpress work, which is the old way of printing, and we do have that system here, and even though it's old, we find it's beneficial educationally. And then eventually they're going to learn how to do and work the offset presses. In the advanced graphic arts course, the students are working with more sophisticated approaches to offset press. They're dealing with darkroom techniques and plate making in preparation. You can see in back of me some of the examples on the bulletin board of silk screening, and you can see some beginning graphic arts students working on their projects along with Mr. Sanborn, the instructor. Let's take a look at the two metalworking courses that we offer in the industrial arts area. Basic metalworking, it's a semester course, grades 9 through 12. And advanced metalworking, full year course, offered to the 11th and 12th graders. So come on along, let's take a look at what's going on in this room. We have five different areas in the metalworking shop. We have the sheet metal area, machine metal, foundry, the forge, and heat treating, and we have welding. In the basic metal class, the students are required to make a project in all those areas. In the advanced metal class, they are required to make projects that have advanced skills and knowledge. Here are some examples of a sheet metal project done by a beginning student. And we also have a wrought iron table being made where there's a lot of welding involved. And we also have a cold chisel that is made in the forge area and the heat treating. The students are using some of the traditional metal machines that you see in a lot of the shops around the area, such as a lathe, a planer, a milling machine. And as an advanced metalworking student, they're going to be introduced to the concepts behind a numerically controlled lathe, such as this one. This is a new machine last year. They learn how a computer program is fed directly into a manufacturing lathe and actually can turn out products automatically, such as this chess piece. This piece of equipment is state-of-the-art, and it's something we're trying to get and update the entire area. Hopefully in the future we'll add more of these kinds of machines in the industrial arts area. We're in the foundry area right now, and in front of me you can see a sand mold. And you can see the molten metal that has just been poured here. And over here, we can see one of the sand molds that has been pulled apart, and you can see the product. In this case, it appears to be some kind of aluminum weight that they're going to cast. This is the kind of project they get involved with. We can also deal with projects such as plaques that many people would put on their walls. This particular plaque was poured in this foundry at the Amesbury High School. In the hot metals area, we have a forge where they will do some heating of metal before they actually put it on the old black iron here. And we'll also do some heat treating in this furnace so that when they're done, they can make instruments such as screwdrivers, cold chisels, and pinch bars. Kind of an interesting area. It really brings back the good old days like the village blacksmith. Area. The students have an experience in doing arc welding, such as with this small one, or the large arc welder down in the middle, or acetylene oxygen welding, or what we call TIG welding, which is used when you have to weld material such as aluminum. What we're looking at is a basic metalworking class, and you can see it's a pretty active group doing all kinds of activities, and that's what industrial arts is all about. A lot of different kinds of experiences so they can better explore what they think they might want to do in the future. Kind of a fun area to be in. We're back in the metal shop. This is also the area that we teach automotive maintenance. It's a semester course, open to grades 11 and 12. This is the course where if you own a car, this is where you belong in terms of learning how to service the various systems that you'll find in your automobile. When you consider that the car will be the second most expensive thing you'll purchase in your lifetime, this is a course that I think everybody should be taking before they graduate from Amesbury High School. In front of me, you'll see some engines. In back of me, you'll see some others, plus cars. And these engines and cars will be worked upon by students learning about the various systems. You'll also they'll also use some equipment for testing and servicing various components of their automobile. So why don't we come on down here and take a closer look at what some of these students are working on. Of their choice. What we have here is a beginning class, so they're dealing with objects that are relatively simple in their construction. And what we should do right now is take a few minutes and take a close-up look of some of the projects that these students are doing in the beginning woodworking course. This young man is making a closet organizer. It's going to go into his closet. The upper level of the closet and directly below that will be where he hangs his clothes, but it's a nice looking job, simple in construction, but nonetheless the workmanship seems to be right where it belongs for this level. Young man is working on the drill press to prepare a piece of wood for his project. This is typical of some of the basic equipment that they're learning to use. Examples of beginning woodworking projects. You can see the gun rack on the bench, and you can see the bookcase that's on the floor. This bookcase is of his design, and it's rather unusual and rather nicely done, I think. One of the other courses that we offer at the high school is Career Industrial Arts. The students in this course are going to learn about the duties and responsibilities of what a job is all about. They'll learn some simple tasks. They'll also learn how a company is run. For example, they will establish a company, determine the project they want to manufacture, and actually manufacture the product, in some cases for sale. In other cases, it's for them to take home to their parents. And Mr. Perot, the instructor, will deal with them in terms of how do they approach a job? What are their responsibilities on the job? What happens if they get sick? So that when they leave this course, they'll have a better understanding of what their boss is going to expect of them while they are working on a job site. In back of me, you can see some students working on some of the projects. They are producing a wall lamp, which is kind of an interesting one because it's going to include the metal working area also. And they've also built a small wooden mobile that was hanging in one of our demonstration windows during the first marking period. This is the projection room above and in back of the high school auditorium. And this is where the structure students are building partitions for TV studio, control room, and storage room. As you can see, this is a concrete room, and some of the walls are not plumb, and we have some steel beams in here. So this is going to present some rather interesting problems for the structure students. They're presently working on some partitions right now, so let's go over and take a look at them and see what they're doing. What you see here are the partitions for the storage room unit. It's merely held in place with bracing for the moment until they can fasten it securely to the concrete floor. You might add that we're going to have to put paneling on this outer wall before they put it in place because you can't get by the pipe rail that is there. And on the floor, we have another partition being constructed, framed in, which will also contain a window, and that is the end wall for the control room. So you can see that in-house projects are also done by structure students. So Keith, what are you doing right now? What's
installing the pilot fuel set on this window area.
Okay. Okay, I can see. Yeah, you've got to nail these cripple studs in to your header up here. All right, and this will go up in place after you get the nailing done. Will go up in place. Okay. Furniture, the students are expected to make major pieces of furniture using all the power equipment that you can see around me and behind me. The students are going to learn various kinds of joinery and fabrication, building things such as hutches, desks, tables, stereo component cabinets, and the like. When they leave this course, they will have a pretty good in-depth idea of what furniture making is all about, and they could probably get some jobs as a cabinet maker or a woodworker in some of the local cabinet making industries in the area. Another course that we're offering is basic electricity electronics. It's open to grades 10 through 12, and it's a semester course. In that course, they learn about the basics of electronic components, circuitry, and the use of some of the measuring devices to check some of these components. They are also working on some things that are very practical. For example, right in back of me now, they are working on a wiring board so they can learn the basics of some house wiring that they might want to try in their own home. This particular class just returned from a shadowing experience at Data General, which is a manufacturer of computer boards, and they spent most of the day with engineers and technicians, not only touring the place, but actually sitting down, talking with, and watching these high-tech people in action. Hopefully in the future, we're going to be able to offer an advanced electronics course. Now, how would that be used? Where would you put this? Where would that go? Seriously, if you were to use it in the house?
I don't know, a door or something probably.
Thoughts?
You want that to open the door and trip
it
around
the wire. So if the circuit is broken around the house, the window, something like that.
Nice.
Put a wire on it. You got two different circuits. One
when the switch opens, when the circuit opens, it goes on, and another one is normally open, so if something closes the circuit, it goes on. It's got two different options there.
They weren't a quarter of an inch apart. They were like so many thousands, 6,000 apart or something like that.
Really is nothing.
Hey, man.
What are you doing right here?
Setting up two two-way switches to light up the same light, like in a hallway or something, from two ends of the hall.
All right. You need two three-ways to control it from two positions.
Yep.
It is.
It's just light.
The light can line up.
Yeah.
Goes on to the outlet.
White door. Oh, that's right. You're under the
street. No.
Well, that's the program. I hope you have found it to be informative and interesting. The students will begin registering for next year's courses, and they should come down and visit the Industrial Arts area. They should come in and bring some friends with them, talk to me, and then sign up for an Industrial Arts course. For the adults out there in the community, come on down and visit and talk with me. You might find something of interest for you also. You know, we have a powerful combination at Amesbury High School. We have strong academics and we have some strong electives. With the right combination, you can write yourself a ticket to a very bright future. So let's get on with it. Let's get to your future. Come on down and sign up for an Industrial Arts program. At this time, I'd like to thank Frank Gurczak for his technical and creative help in developing this video, and also the New England Cable people for allowing us to use their facility for the editing of this program. Thanks for watching. Come on down.